Hi there, I'm Dona Marabe from the Philippines, here to discuss the concept of limits in mathematics. According to Steven Strugatz, our non-mathematician and Cornell Applied Mathematics professor, calculus reveals the secrets of the universe. It goes from explaining basic concepts like how the area of a square can be calculated and equate to a finite number even when adding the areas of its infinite divisions, to complex concepts like the bounds of space and time itself. By Wikipedia's definition, calculus is simply the mathematical study of continuous change, the math of infinities. The foundations of calculus, however, lie within the concept of limits. Particularly, this is easier to understand through this personal visualization. This is Mojo. He is our baby hamster, and today we'll be having a mini race. To account for Mojo being pretty tiny, I'll be giving him a head start. Now, this problem shows that there'd be a point wherein I'd catch up to his starting point, but he'd have moved further. This could go on forever. I'd move faster than Mojo, but theoretically, I could never catch him. I could only ever decrease his lead. This is Zeno's paradox, and it's called such because it raises the concern that motion might be impossible, since to get from one point to another, you'd need to travel an infinite number of steps. On the other hand, basic physics supports the idea that there'd be a finite distance I need to travel to do so, and they actually might be able to outrun Mojo. This makes Zeno's idea even more complicated. Thankfully, some infinities are bigger than other infinities. This would be familiar if you're a John Green fan, like me, or a believer of Cantor's proof. There might be an infinite number of steps I need to take to travel from one point to another, but this is also true for Mojo. The intersection of Zeno's paradox and basic physics would be to consider that Mojo's infinite number of steps is simply somehow bigger than mine. Limits point to this overall concept, showing that as the number reaches a certain point, or in this case, as the number of steps I need to reach Mojo's lead approaches zero, the time it would take for me to reach him could ultimately be computed. Calculus leads us to finding patterns and relationships to the universe's countless infinities, stemming from the principal foundations of limits, truly deserving the term of calculus being the math of infinities. Thank you for listening!